game, the splendid splitter, Ted Williams.
Ted, the sign when you come in the door, remember, you said that all you really want was when you walk down the street for people to say, there goes the greatest hitter that ever lived. Well, now you've got a museum that says, here's the greatest hitter who ever lived. How exciting is it?
Well, I want to tell you something, Peter. This, I've never said this before, but it's the truth. I go to a banquet or I go any place where there's a lot of great players, and then we get an announcer, he gets carried away, and he says, Ted Williams, greatest hitter that ever lived. Well, you're right on my quote, because I always hoped that would be true. But when that guy announces that, and I'm sitting in the chair, greatest hitter that ever lived, I try to get a little lower if I can, because in my heart, I can't honestly say I think I was better than Babe Ruth, or Lou Gehrig, or Jimmy Fox, or Rogers Hornsby. Jesus, a lot of those guys. I think I belong in the company of some of them. But to say I was the best, I don't know how you're ever going to prove that. You can do it by statistics some way, but I feel satisfied with whatever position they put me in as in the group of the top hitters in baseball history.
What about some of the guys that are playing today? Barry Bonds.
He's a big, strong guy. He chokes up a couple of inches on the bat. I don't know how anybody in the world could ever think he's going to throw it by him inside. And when they do, it's boom, you know. But he is from a family background. Father was a great player. He's a great player. And he'll pick it all up.
What about Frank Thomas?
Frank Thomas is big and strong, has continued with his best style. You're lucky when you pick up the style that's best adapted to you and your talent and stay with it and you're having success with it, just keep going. That's what Frank Thomas is doing, and he's doing a great job. He's so devastating by being so strong and powerful. He hit it off the out that way and it's gone, and hits it that way, it's gone.
So give you a good feeling when you know that every time he goes to the plate, he's saying to himself, I'm not going to swing until I get a good ball to hit.
Well, that's number one thing. I asked Rogers Hornsby, as good as anybody ever went to the plate. And I said, what's the most single important thing I've got to do? And he said, get a good ball to hit. Boy, that was in 1938. He was right on the money, and I've preached it ever since.
What about Ken Griffey Jr.?
Equally as talented as anybody else in the league. He, tremendous, tremendous. I can think of the ball he hit the left center in the All-Star game, where was it, 3 years ago? Home run. And it was hit like a bullet in the left center. And I said, boy, that's outstanding. And he seems to be conducting himself great. And talent plus.
What about Gonzalez?
Muscles. Strong. Aggressive. He reminds me more real quick of Frank Robinson than anybody else I know.
What about Paul Molitor?
One of the best hitters I have ever seen. I told him that the other day. He is absolutely a great hitter. And you know what? Nobody's seen this. Nobody said this. And you haven't said it. Every time Molitor comes to play, and every time he swings, all I can see is DiMaggio.
Now, you and Joe DiMaggio, contemporaries who always compared, is it fun now to think back to how the two of your careers went together?
Well, I'm pretty embarrassed when they compare me with DiMaggio. I really, in my heart, think he's the greatest player I ever saw. I enjoy being with him. I've admired him so much as a player. I know how great he was. And we have a lot of fun together. I truly admire him.
A lot of the old advertisements that you were in.
Yeah.
You look back, you remember, how good was Ted's Root Beer?
Well, it was pretty good, but Jesus, we had A&W, Hires, Frosty. They had a lot of good root beers. And still, and they had a product they should have run with, but they didn't. They come out with another root beer, and it wasn't as good as the three or four best ones. And so, understandably, we didn't do as well as we thought we were going to do. And they blamed it on me. Ted Williams can't sell root beer. Well, that's all right.
Sunday Conversation was brought to you by Sprint.